Good day, fellas! I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill, and today we are going to play with Toaster. Have you ever heard about this tank? This vehicle, fellas, is not in the tech tree. You might think, skill what? This tank you can buy from the collections market, or however it's called in World of Tanks, right? And you are finding it right there. Back in the day, it used to be in the tech tree, but by the looks of it, Wargaming simply removed it. And instead of having a toaster right there, they are having Stug. And from the Stug, you can get towards the Grille line, and you can go towards the Jackpizder line, right? And before saying skill, toaster, flagpole, whatever, hear me out. This tank is actually pretty damn crazy. we managed to craft 3 extremely good games with it, and I would highly recommend to check them out. I know it is lower tier, I know not many of you love this vehicle with all your heart, but oh boys, this is pretty damn good tank, okay? This is pretty damn good vehicle, fellas. Speaking about the gun usage, it is a tier 5, by the way. Standard ammunition 194 millimeters of penetration. Some tier 8s do not have this penetration. Gold penetration 240. Once again, some tier 8s do not have this penetration. Or alternatively, you can use the gun with more arc, which is also usable, because with this gun, if you want to play with this gun, then you have only a couple of degrees angle to work with. When you are taking this gun, which is a bit shittier one in my opinion, then you have this kind of arc to work with. So in the end of the day, it depends what do you prefer. But I preferred this gun, and I had an extremely good time playing with this thing. So, without further ado, Toaster, let's teleport into the game. And fellas, trust me on this one when I'm saying the games will be good, okay? So let's go there. Kaboom! And we magically teleported into the very first battle, which is on the map, which is called Westfield. Extremely good map for a tanks which can play hold down, but if you cannot play hold down, you can do one very, very simple strategy, and that simple strategy is to take this sniper Schnitzel bushwanker position here. It is extremely powerful, it is extremely good, and I would highly recommend to use it if you are playing with any sniper tank, right? Now look, this is going to be pretty damn long game, and skill tier 4, not impressive, skill. Watch this battle and then talk once again. Meanwhile, Lux is going through the middle of the nowhere. Unfortunately, we did not manage to punish this guy, and you can see how the gun is going like this a bit, because I need to pretty much move to the left or to the right side. As you can see right there, you have literally 5 to 10 degrees angle, or 5 degrees on one side, 5 degrees on the other side, but it is completely fine. By the way, pay attention what I'm doing here. This is extremely good thing for beginners if you are a beginner in the World of Tanks. I'm going into the bush, and before shooting, I am going out of the bush. What that basically means, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, that basically means we are not going to get spotted. Even though we might not have the best camo ever, we are going in the bush and we are going out of the bush, and that's how we are getting pretty much maximum use of all this, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. And it works extremely well, and I would highly recommend to use this kind of strategy yourself if you never ever used one like this before, okay? It is very, very important thing. Meanwhile, Churchill is trying to escape, but we are obviously not going to allow him to do so. And look at this crazy, I repeat, crazy performance. This is already pretty damn good game, fellas. I'm not even joking. This is pretty damn good game. Considering we have only 460 HP or something, what we are doing here, it is pretty damn good. What is so damn good about this vehicle overall? This tank have crazy mobility for a tier 5 toaster, okay? Usually toasters cannot relocate, but this one can. So keep this in mind. relocation of this vehicle is pretty damn good, and everything is fine with this vehicle, speaking about this. After that, gun penetration, once again, like I said and highlighted, gun is just ideal, gun is pretty much perfect. Once again, we definitely can't complain about this. By the way, Waka tried to make a bit of pressure, but in the end of the day, he got effed. And this is very, very good thing. Luckily, we had a Churchill which farmed him, right? Another Toaster. Actually, this is Toaster's sister, I would even say. And this is a lower tier shitter, but you know, we are not complaining about this. We are just simply taking his life and we are saying good night for him. We are sending him to the garage. Ticket to the garage, fellas. Situation is looking okay for now. It is 6-7 score, which is completely fine. We are only 3 minutes into the first battle, which is completely fine. And I'm trying to figure out where the flying F Stug is. And as you can see, we are not getting spotted. What that means? That means we could be a bit more involved, fellas, into this game, right? And now I'm trying to figure out what the flying F do I want to do. Do I want to escape from here, or do I want to still sit in the same position, because we can't do that much stuff anymore, and there is only M10, Stug, Matilda, Panzer, 14 TP and Lux left. Maybe I could actually be just tiny touch more involved, and in fact I am doing this. So I decided to relocate a bit. To be exact, I want to take this hill over there, so maybe from this hill we will be able to get some shots into the people which is playing around this area. Or alternatively, maybe we are going to find a beautiful angle to beat the living crap out of the Mr. Lux here. That would be very, very nice. But in the same time, I'm a bit paranoid about enemy Arta, which can easily one-shot this tank, fellas. I'm not exaggerating this. There was 5 battles in a row. Not whatever 5 battles. 5 battles in a row when we got pretty much one-shotted by the Arta, or farmed by Arta by a couple of shots. It is madness in the lower tier how powerful Jeffs are. It is absolutely disgusting. Speaking of the Jeff, how are you doing, mister? I have high explosive ammunition for you. Look at the Jeff moving here. Look at him go. Nope. And Jeff is saying, trying to move. Not today, not on my shift, mother trucker. Beautiful. We are sitting on the 5 kills already and 2,500 damage, and luckily Stug did not spotted us. The Stug have a derp gun, as you can see, small PP that indicates a derp gun, and oh boys, if the Stug is going to hit us with a derp gun, it's going to be game over. I'm trying to find the angle to beat the living crap out of the Lux. Unfortunately, I did not manage to do that. Well, I was trying very, very hard, but it is how it is, right? In the end of the day, he is dead, although I could save a bit of HP for Mr. Churchill left. I could save pretty much a bit of the Churchill HP, that's what I was trying to say. Anyways. 4-3 situation. They are winning on HP. But in my opinion, they are winning on positions, because M10 is pretty much not allowing Churchill to cap the base, and whenever they are going to relocate somewhere here, obviously they are going to beat the living crap out of the Mr. Churchill. So now we need to figure out what the flying F is supposed to do. Remember, this tank do not have any armor whatsoever, and this vehicle have a pretty damn awful however you are calling this, how the gun can move, right? The angle arc of the gun, however you would call this. So we need to figure out how to get more involved here, and this is very, very, very complicated situation. So what I decided to do, I decided to simply leave this position, because I don't feel good whatsoever. By the way, in the background, I believe you can hear Katita taking a shit, so don't mind her. She's doing her cat business. Just saying, fellas. So once again, patience is the key, especially in the lower tier gameplay. I know that I figured this out by playing lower tiers myself, currently in the Rus server, right? Because I'm trying to mark some lower tiers, and I marked quite a bit of them, and some games were completely madness, and I found some hidden gems, like the same VK30.01 hash. That tank is absolutely nuts. So I will share that with you very, very soon. Meanwhile, there is 40 TP, which is making a hardcore pressure, but we are not afraid. Even though we missed the first shot, it doesn't really change anything. We are trying to make as much pressure as we can. We are trying to hit him in the face, and we are ramming him to death. I still think it was better idea to ram him than to wait until he's going to hit us twice, right? Even though we lost pretty much 60% of HP, not much what we can change about that, unfortunately. Meanwhile, we are trying to get a good angle to the M10, but we cannot. And once again, we are on the... we are on the 7 minutes of the battle, and this is very, very complicated situation. You might say whatever you want, but skill, it's easy to win. No, it's not. Whenever enemies are pretty damn patient, it is extremely, I repeat, extremely hard to win the game, right? Especially when they know what they are doing, and by the looks of it, Mr. Igor is not suiciding, Matilda is not suiciding, Andrei and Vova is saying nope. Absolutely not. And we need to figure out the different thing, how the flying F is supposed to approach them. And I decide to completely relocate from here, and I want to take the position somewhere in the Delta Zero, or alternatively Charlie Zero, because from that position we can be the living crap out of the M10, right? Which makes sense. By the way, did you notice at how fast we picked up 8 kills? Yeah, and there is 3 more kills to get, but the question is, will we get those 3 kills, huh? What do you think, fellas? Does it smelling like a pulse or victory or defeat? What do you think? Don't you dare to cheat, by the way. Meanwhile, Matilda is making a bit of pressure here, which is not very, very good thing for us. I'm trying to get a very, very nice angle here. I'm trying to help the Churchill, and Churchill is getting killed. That's bad. Because he is our eyes, my friends. The Churchill is our eyes, and we have 5 minutes of the battle left. And once again, the things are not looking good whatsoever. Plus, on top of that, enemies are winning on the HP. At least I think enemies are winning by HP, although there is a chance the Panzer Toaster have less HP than it is registered, because he was out of our view zone, or however you would call this. So I am praying for the Bishop to survive there, and we are simply getting into the better position for ourselves, because we want to see the cap. But you know what, bad things happened. M10 noticed that Bishop is alone, not protected, or maybe he doesn't know he's alone, but he's just having a big crush on the Bishop, and the situation is looking pretty damn bad, and I cannot support the Bishop. I would love to help this guy somehow, and as you can see, desperately I am trying to shoot via the houses here, just to check it out. Can I go through, or I cannot go through? And unfortunately, I can't. By the way, I believe there is some people which will ask skill. Why the flying F you are using anonymizer? I am using anonymizer on the Russian server, my friends. This is very, very important thing to say. I do not use anonymizer on the O server, but in Ru server I am using it, because no one from the Russian region knows who the flying F I am, and to show my stats and say, fellas, bang me, please. Especially for Artas, I am not willing to do that. On our server, it's a different thing, because people know who I am, they want to say hi, and once again, that's understandable. But in Ru region, they have their own content creators, which they are watching and which they are enjoying. Meanwhile, what we noticed M10 is capping the base, so what we need to do, we need to be a bit more involved, and we need to beat the living crap out of him, right? It is extremely important thing, and that's what we are attempting to do. Fellas, this is going to be pretty damn interesting part. So, what do we have? We are obviously trying to make some kind of pressure. I would be so much more happier if I would not knock this tree down, but I did. So once again, I cannot complain about this. Mistakes were made, and we are trying to approach him. I hope he's not going to notice where I am, but he did. And now we have a problem. This M10 is a good player. He knows exactly what he is doing. And fellas, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, he's going for the bloody victory. He's going for the victory. So I'm trying to relocate a bit and maybe I can get myself into the bush from where I could potentially spot this mother trucker. And as you can see, I am following from bush to bush, from bush to bush. And unfortunately, this mother trucker outspotted us, but I'm saying not today. And we are picking up the lucky gore, but now the situation is looking a bit different. I am going to speed this up, fellas. I was thinking the Panzer is going to go for us since I am down to one shotable, but unfortunately it wasn't the case, and everything finished off with a drop, which is quite sad thing, but once again, not much what we can do about this. We just need to accept the situation. By the way, fellas, a flagpole raised in the bush. I was thinking maybe with this kind of gun elevation, we are going to spot the Panzer before he will spot us, but unfortunately, he decided to go for a drop. But once again, I can understand this guy. There's some kind of Panzer toaster in the enemy team, which have 10 kills. Oh, I am not going to give him victory. And once again, this is understandable, right? And funny thing, we will speak about this funny thing very, very soon. Let's teleport into the other game. And if you thought this battle was good, the next game probably is going to be even better. You don't believe in me? Watch this. Poochoo! And we are back with a second game. So watch this, fellas. What did you expect? Did you expect Malinovka sniping from the back? Prokurovka sniping from the back? Or maybe you expected something else, like, I don't even know, whatever. Airfield sniping from the back. Nope, fellas, it is a bit different situation. We are having a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful experience in the Corridor Pass version 1. Because Corridor Pass version 2 is the Chinese map, right? Empire's Border. So this is definitely not what you want to see, my friends. You don't want to see those kind of situations or those kind of maps on the with the tank destroyers, which is absolutely pile of crap. Speaking about the armor skill, did you put the wrong replay skill? Did you messed up skill? What? Yeah, skill. This is how the skill level is just increasing. One peak, lost 2/3 of HP, going back to spawn. Okay, fellas, going back home. No. This is going to be extremely epic battle. By saying extremely epic battle, fellas, you don't really have choice. You need to trust me, right? And I do not lie to you. I do not have those kind of stupid ideas, if I can say so. So what do we have? We have the tier 5. Mountain Pass, which is looking like a pile of caco. I made a mistake. I decided to be aggressive with the tank destroyer. I lost 2/3 of HP. I'm sitting on 190 HP left, and everything is looking pretty damn bad. Our team is losing by 1000 HP, which is looking like a pile of shit, like I said before. We are pretty much useless in a way here, because we cannot do absolutely anything. And in this kind of situation, majority of the people would say, nahren, I'm going to drown or something. Well, maybe not majority players, I apologize. Probably that's definitely not true. Some people would simply give up and say, I'm going into the other battle, I will push in front, and I won't torture myself. That's not me, fellas. I will try to get as much as I can get, speaking about the use, and maybe even win the game, right? You never know how the things are going to look like. Our Cavalier is AFK, our Cava 1 is protecting the base, our Churchill is somewhere in the ice road. Yeah, the things are not looking too great, but you know what? There is one plot twist to this game and to this map itself. You might wonder, Skill, what is that plot twist? This map is the map of Humongous Keres. There is, in the both sides of the map, there is very, very good positions from where you can farm pretty much entire enemy team. You don't believe in me? Watch this. Obviously, before that, we are going to try to get one shot, and even not getting the shot. With all respect, not even getting the shot, okay? So yeah, it looks promising. -2000 HP, we are sitting on zero, we don't have any hit points left for ourselves. It is looking like a big pile of garbage. But you know what? Don't beat the living hell out of your desk. Don't beat the living hell out of your chair. It is not the time yet. I'm speeding this up because there is not too many action, and we are going to do something very, very special. And what we are going to do, we are going to beat the living crap out of the M10. One shot made from this position, and I am thinking I don't want to play over there. You know why? Because there is a cover one downstairs. There is a cavalier which is sitting here, and what we need to do, we need to craft the bush. And skill, could you please tell us how the flying F you are making the nest for yourself as a professional sniper schnitzel? Answer is simple. You are knocking every single tree down while you have a chance. And while you have a time. Why so? Because trees are bushes in this game, right? Trees are giving you camo, more trees you have on top of each other, pretty much better camo you are having and better situation you are having overall for yourself. Now, I want to, fellas, let's stop this video for a second and tell me, do you think this is winnable? We have cover one, we have a bloody toaster, and we have Churchill which is traveling in the other side of the map. What do you think? Is it winnable? Leave your comment down below, and don't you dare to cheat if you seen this on stream or if you watched it already and then you are commenting. Don't be a bad boy, okay? So when we have this out of the way, let's continue our bush building. We are losing by 2000 HP, which is not very, very good thing. I'm politely asking this guy to go back. Man, go back. When I get it, you are having a great time. But listen, we might actually win this battle, my man. And here you go. Cover one is getting rushed by the shit on of the enemies. And this gun, oh boys. 240 alpha damage. Look at this zombie horde, zombie apocalypse. Everyone is saying, and they're slaughtering the living hell out of the T1 heavy, and you know what, we need to eliminate the guns. I'm trying to aim for one shots for obvious reasons, and oh boys, fellas, we are doing the job here. I'm trying to get a bit out of the bush just to spot the people here, and look at this. Meanwhile, getting once again into the bush and working them out. That's one mother trucker down. Meanwhile, Matilda is thinking, I wonder how. And once again, fellas, we are not panicking too much. We are feeling pretty damn good by sitting in the bush. That was a very, very sad shot, unfortunately. But we are not giving up yet. We are trying to beat the living crap out of the M10 for obvious reasons. Meanwhile, cover one is saying, oh, I think I know where this mother trucker is. We are tracking him because we can. Once again, moving out of the bush, shooting him once again. He just missed his shot, which is extremely good for us, because if he would hit us, that would be pretty damn sad. Cover one is making pressure. Once again, I'm trying to move out of the bush as much as I can, and boom, cover one is going home. Meanwhile, on this other side, Churchill just died. Meanwhile, there's Matilda, which is having a great time and trying to cap the base, and I'm saying, not today, my friend, not today. Officially, this situation was 1v4, if I'm not mistaken, currently 1v3, and you know what, he is going to go back home because he got high roller twice, so jokes on him, I was lucky, right? Meanwhile, we have 8 minutes on the timer left. We know the M10 Panther is here, and now it is a patience game, fellas. We was waiting for shit enough time, fellas. We was waiting for a lot of time there, but in the end of the day, it definitely paid off. Now let's try to speed the things up a bit, right? I am speeding the things up for obvious reasons, because I am pretty much waiting until something will happen, right? Not to waste 5 minutes of your time. And whenever something will happen, we are going to show you what exactly happened, right? Somewhere about here, I believe. I am slowing the things down, and here we go. We have the T67, which is making a hardcore pressure. Unfortunately, I failed hitting him with high explosives, which is pretty damn sad thing, but I'm not going to give up. The T67 got effed, because once again, we spotted him way earlier and in time, and now I'm not even bothering to get into the bush. I'm just simply eliminating the M10, and fellas, this is as close as you can get for Kolobanovs, and even though we lost all our HP in the start of the battle, we still managed to bang literally half of the enemy team like there is no tomorrow. 9 kills, fellas. 9 kills. And you think we are done? You think we are done? I have one more for you, especially for those games when you have no bloody clue what to do with a tank destroyer. What do you think about Ensk? Huh? Let's go. Pachu! And we are back, fellas. Like I promised for you before, Ensk with pretty damn bad matchmaking. I mean, it's not -2, it's -1, but still, it is not the greatest matchmaking ever. So what I want to show you, fellas, how to get some use whenever you are playing with the tanks like Bloody Toaster or Flagpole, however you would call this vehicle. You see, obviously, the worst thing about this tank is you do not have any armor whatsoever, but it doesn't mean you cannot do anything. This is a magical bush in Ensk, which I would recommend for everyone to use, because you can punish people which is traveling like M10, and it works so much better. In the past, I used to use this bush, but in the same time, you don't really have a cover there. But in this kind of situation, fellas, as you can see, after you are getting spotted, you are going in and you are pretty much safe. And all you need to do, you need to be patient here. So patience is the key. You are simply waiting until someone will make a bit of pressure. And whenever someone will make a bit of pressure, obviously you are going to simply punish them. Now, pay humongous attention to the maxi map. There is pretty much no one which is playing in the city apart the M10, which will get slaughtered, and T-3485, which will get slaughtered. I'm thinking, do I want to help him? Nah, not really. Maybe one shot. Kaboom. We are hitting this guy for once, and now we are running for our life like there is no tomorrow, fellas. It looks like it is game over. It looks like there is nothing what we can do, but you know what? I am running. I have a bloody long legs, fellas. I have a very long leg. See you later, alligator. Bye-bye. One of the most important things in the game is to know when to escape. And as you can see, luckily in this battle, we managed to figure out when we need to run away. And once again, in this kind of situation, we are using our guys, which is taking one for the team as a shield. I know it sounds very, very, very weird and very, very bad, but you see, our VK is getting slaughtered, our IKEA is getting slaughtered, and we are running. And even though the situation is looking pretty damn bad, we are 1,500 HP minus, we are still somewhere in that range to support our guys if enemies are going to be aggressive against them. Here you go. One guy down, hip hip hooray. Now, once again, we are just simply waiting until the T-34 will make a bit of pressure, if obviously he will make a bit of pressure. And yes, he's going for it. So here you go, buddy. Greetings from the skill. Meanwhile, another guy is speaking, and we are hitting him in the face. And this is how you are trying to play with the tank destroyers, which don't really have too much armor or any armor whatsoever. You are simply trying to be obviously as passive as possible, because you simply cannot afford to lose neither any HP or neither anything, unless obviously your team is winning, then you are pushing with your forces, right? This is the right way to do the things. But in this kind of situation, you need to be a bit greedy bastard and simply use the your team HP in order to get more use. And you know what? Hate me, love me, but this kind of decision is going to help us to win the game if obviously we are going to win the game. And for now, we are just waiting until enemies will make a pressure and until they will pretty much die. I know about the shitland, but his speed is pathetic, so I don't really care about him, and I want to eliminate the gun. And as you can see, M10 is eliminated. Now we are checking out the situation. Majority of the enemy tanks are one-shotable. Even though we are losing 9-11, it doesn't really change anything. So what we are doing, instead of hiding somewhere in the back, now we are starting to use our HP. So we are going in front and we are saying, no, mother truckers, how are you doing? We are safe from the Mr. Hellcat, because now we know Hellcat is sitting here. So what we need to do, we need to eliminate the Mr. Jackson. Jackson is eliminated. Beautiful. Now, fellas, before it's too late, obviously we are going to go towards the Mr. Hellcat, and we want to say hi for him. Hellcat is there. Hellcat is dead. just like this, with a finger slap, fellas, we are kind of winning the game by the amount of the tanks. But before yelling skill, it's not victory, I'm very, very well aware of that. Enemies are making the cap pressure, enemies are having HP advantage, but in the same time, fellas, this is exactly... imagine that, if we would sit here, we would get a couple of shots instead of escaping, it would be game over in 100%, right? And by running from that position in time, by noticing the situation, we need to escape, right? This is the score which we are having, fellas. We are sitting on 2,700 damage already, which, if you would ask me, is pretty damn nuts for the Ensk map with a bloody toaster, okay? It is pretty damn nuts, fellas. Meanwhile, we know 82 is shooting high explosive ammunition, so we are waiting until this guy will shoot or until this guy will turn. I am preparing to peek against him. He just fired, so I am thinking about peeking. Plus, on top of that, he's not looking to the side. What that means? That means we are taking our time to aim, and we are thinking, nah, you are not going to hit us in this way, will you? And obviously he failed, which is very, very good thing. Now we can speed the things up a bit, right? And we are going for the last remaining clicker, which is hiding in the corner, as majority of the clickers do. We are getting some speed and we are banging him like this. Fellas, it is great game considering what kind of situation we had there. Aka Ensk. Your bottom tier tank destroyer, and simply reaction to the map was pretty damn good, if you would ask me. So now what we are going to do, we are going to teleport into the scoreboard and we'll see how everything is looking like, fellas. Are you excited? Because I am. Let's go. Pachu! And we are back in the scoreboard. So the very first battle, Westfield, unfortunately draw, but it was pretty damn great, fellas. Score, draw, ace vanker, pull medal, top gun, high caliber, 1000 base experience for defeat, which is quite sad, but you know, I am pretty damn happy with this game. Anyways, I believe it's clear we did more than majority of our team while having 10 kills. That's understandable. And we made 46,000 profits because we did not fire a single gold shell, which is understandable with a toaster. And if you are a free-to-play player, if you love bushwanking, this could work very, very well. Then we had a mountain pass where we managed to win the game, which was, in my opinion, very close to unwinnable. Ace vanker, Radley Walter, stop gun, high caliber with a whopping 3,000 damage, which is pretty damn insane. If you would ask me, it's tier 5. You have 400 HP or 470 HP. That's pretty much nothing, but we managed to do that. Obviously, enemies wasn't the most experienced because they did not push it towards us, because if they would, they would win the game, but it is how it is. Another 40,000 profits, and last but not least, Ensk. When we realized the situation and when we started running away, which was very, very good in my opinion, we have the Ace Vanker, obviously, Top Gun high caliber, and we finished with 1.4 base experience and 3,300 damage dealt, which was extremely good, and another 44,000 profits, which is just insane, and which is bloody good if you would ask me. So fellas, as you can see, even though the tank is not looking too appetizing, the tank can have extremely great battles overall, and our average performance with the tank, we needed 105 games in order to complete this, which is a lot of games, but in the same time we did, that's all that matters. 60% win ratio straight, and we have 1,300 damage and about 200 assisting damage, which is not looking that great, fellas, but considering this tank have 470 HP, and whenever you are winning the game, sometimes it's very, very hard to do something. I would call it great success. So my friends, thank you very much for watching. If you watch till then, you are the hero of the day. Thank you very much for that. And give it a go. Give a toaster a go. Plus, remember, if you are raising your PP, you can raise the gun up to 90 degrees angle, which is always fun. And new players will look at you like, what? And this is pretty damn good if you would ask me. So once again, thank you very much for watching. That was your daily dose of skill, and skill is out. Peace. Pachoo!